So let's talk about sinus infection. Most people with upper respiratory infection develop nasal congestion and sinus pressure. However, that doesn't mean that everybody with sinus infection needs antibiotics. So when do you need antibiotic to treat sinusitis?
Hi, I'm Dr. D, and in this video, I'll go over the major differences between the bacterial and sinus infections. I'll also discuss when antibiotics are appropriate and when they absolutely should not be used. Additionally, I'll mention several treatment options to help you deal with the sinus infection that will give you instant relief whether you use antibiotics or not.
So you mentioned that not every sinusitis needs antibiotics. Can you be more specific?
Yes, so the main thing I would like everybody to get from this video is that most sinusitis is caused by viruses. On average, only 2-3% of sinusitis is complicated by bacterial sinusitis that requires antibiotics. Most people with sinusitis only need something to relieve their pain and pressure in their sinuses. The body will take care of the rest.
Sounds great, fewer antibiotics. Can you elaborate on what makes sinusitis more likely to be bacterial versus viral?
Well, the one main factor to help us distinguish one from another is time. Most viral sinusitis generally resolve in about a week. If the sinusitis lasts longer than 10 days without improvement, it's more likely than not that this may actually be bacterial sinusitis. So again, time is generally the major factor to distinguish these two. Another common pattern is so-called double sickening. In this case, the viral sinusitis was getting somehow better, and then it started getting worse again. Now the patient has lots of sinus pain, swelling, and purulent discharge coming from her nose, and may even have a fever. So again, if the sinusitis has been present for less than a week, I hate the word never, but we can say pretty much that it's almost never bacterial sinusitis.
So could you tell us what are the main symptoms of sinusitis?
Sure, so most people develop what's called maxillary sinusitis, which is the facial pain in the cheek next to the nose, or ethmoid sinusitis, which is pain around the nose bridge. Now frontal sinusitis, which is pain right around the forehead, is actually quite rare, but at the same time poses more risk for some more serious complications. So sinus pressure is probably the most telling symptoms, but people usually experience also runny nose, stuffy nose, and generally thick, discolored mucus discharge, and sometimes headache. Some people may also develop the yucky postnasal drip.
Great, so now that we know what are the main symptoms of sinusitis, how can we treat it?
Okay, so let me start with the treatment for bacterial sinusitis. The standard treatment for bacterial sinusitis is antibiotics. But I think that it is important to mention that in reality, most bacterial sinusitis will actually resolve on its own, even without antibiotics. However, since antibiotics provide a better cure rate, we usually treat bacterial sinusitis with antibiotics.
Okay, so how about viral sinusitis?
Now, all the following treatment choices that I will mention are primarily geared towards treatment of viral sinusitis, which, as I just mentioned, is the one that most people will experience. But of course, the same treatment strategy can also be used as an adjunct to treatment of bacterial sinusitis when antibiotics are prescribed. I would actually strongly suggest using the following natural treatment strategies for any form of sinusitis to relieve the symptoms and help the body to get the sinusitis under control. Treatment number one, nasal saline. Everybody can and should be using nasal saline for their sinus infection. Saltwater washes, which can be saline lavage or irrigation, can help to keep the nasal passages open by washing out the thick or dry mucus. The saline can also help improve the function of the cilia, which helps to clear the sinuses. This can in turn help prevent the spread of the infection to other sinuses and reduce the postnasal drip. It also can make the nose feel more comfortable by keeping the mucous membranes moist. There are two options for using the nasal saline. You can use the nasal saline in a small spray bottle and apply it topically to your nose as irrigation, or you can do saline lavage, which most people know as the neti pot. We have more information about how to prepare a great herbal saline lavage in an article on our website. Link is in the description below. But in general, if you are going to do the nasal rinse, I always recommend my patients to use chamomile tea as a base for the saline packets instead of plain water. Why? simply because chamomile tea is great for inflammation of any mucous membranes. Now, if you want to be even fancier and get even better effectiveness, it is worth trying to add into the chamomile tea tincture from echinacea and golden seal. Simply add the recommended dosage of the tincture based on your manufacturer's direction to the chamomile tea, and then add the saline packets. You will then use this decoction to rinse your sinuses. The combination of echinacea and golden seal is a great anti-inflammatory as well as antimicrobial herbal preparation and has been used quite extensively in herbal medicine. You can usually buy them both in the same bottle. Steam inhalation. Carefully inhaling steam from a pot of hot water is another popular folk treatment that helps to open the sinuses. The main benefit of breathing in moist, warm steam is that the steam may help ease the feeling of irritation, swelling, and stuffiness in the nasal passages. The moisture may also help thin the mucus in your sinuses, which allows them to empty more easily. This can allow your breathing to return to normal at least for a short period of time. If you want to take a step further, you can add to the hot water a few drops of eucalyptus oil. Eucalyptus oil is often used in steam inhalation to help clear nasal and sinus congestion. It is supposed to work similarly to menthol by acting on the receptors in the nasal mucous membranes, leading to reduction of nasal stuffiness. Going even a step further, you can use, instead of the plain water, chamomile tea as a base and drop the eucalyptus oil into the chamomile tea.
So you just reviewed several natural treatment strategies that we can do at home. But what if that's not enough and we want to add some medication to our treatment? Can you tell us what can we expect to get from our healthcare provider to treat our sinusitis?
Sure. While I'm a very strong believer in trying the natural approaches to treatment of sinusitis first, given my background in Chinese medicine and nutrition, and honestly, in most cases, the treatment option that I just discussed can actually be the only treatment that we need to use, there can be occasions when we may need very quick relief. In this case, I don't see anything wrong in getting a little help from available medication. So let's talk a bit about things that you can get from your healthcare provider to relieve the symptom from sinusitis. Decongestants. One of the medications your provider may prescribe you is a short course of decongestants. They can provide fairly rapid relief of the symptom since they will open the congested nasal passages and allow the mucous secretions to drain. This can be very helpful when you are experiencing lots of sinus pressure. Keep in mind though that the decongestants should not be used for longer than 2 to 3 days. So if you decide to use decongestants, be careful because prolonged use can make the congestion worse by creating what's called a rebound congestion. When that happens, the nose becomes congested constantly unless you use the decongestant to open it. In a way, the body sort of becomes dependent on the medication. Another bad side effect of the long-term use of decongestants is persistent nasal dryness and crusting. Antihistamines. Another medication that is sometimes used for sinusitis is antihistamine. Now, I particularly don't like to use antihistamines because they may cause excessive drying and make the symptoms actually worse. But that's something that you can definitely discuss with your provider and see if that would be a good option in your case. Nasal steroids. The last thing that I'll mention is the use of nasal steroids. While nasal steroids are used primarily for allergic rhinitis, sometimes we can use a short course of nasal steroids, such as Flonase, to help to shrink the swollen nasal mucous membranes and provide faster relief. But not every healthcare provider believes that nasal steroids have a role in treatment of sinusitis. So again, this is something that you and your healthcare provider can discuss to see if that's a good option for you. So I hope that by now you understand the major difference between viral and bacterial sinusitis and that you won't get upset next time if your healthcare provider won't prescribe you an antibiotic to treat your sinusitis. Understand that antibiotics are very powerful and effective medication when used properly. However, they carry their own side effects and should be therefore used only when absolutely necessary. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and we will see you in our next video.